everyone, welcome to Little Scientists, episode number 3. My name is Yannie, and I'm an early childhood educator at Early On Luminous Community Services. Thank you for joining us today. So for today, we will be learning 3 new songs, and we'll be learning a few new experiments. So before we get started, boys and girls, make sure you have a parent or guardian with you so they can supervise and they can help you if you need help. If you're ready, let's get started. Okay, everyone, the first song we're going to sing today is I'm a Little Ice Cube, and it goes like this. I'm a little ice cube, frosty and square. I make things cold everywhere. If it gets too warm, I'd better watch out, 'cause I'll melt without a doubt. Should we try to sing that one more time? Okay, let's go. I'm a little ice cube, frosty and square. I make things cold everywhere. If it gets too warm, I'd better watch out, 'cause I'll melt without a doubt. The next song we're going to be singing is 1 little, 2 little, 3 little ice cubes. And it goes like this. 1 little, 2 little, 3 little ice cubes, 4 little, 5 little, 6 little ice cubes, 7 little, 8 little, 9 little ice cubes, 10 little ice cubes melting in my cup. Should we try to sing that one more time? Okay. 1 little, 2 little, 3 little ice cubes, 4 little, 5 little, 6 little ice cubes, 7 little, 8 little, 9 little ice cubes, 10 little ice cubes melting in my cup. Okay, everyone, the next song we're going to sing is Bubble Bubble Pop, ice cube version. Okay. Let's get started. Ice cube, floating in the water, floating in the water, floating in the water. Ice cube, floating in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Can we try to sing that one more time? Okay, let's go. Ice cube, floating in the water, floating in the water, floating in the water. Ice cube, floating in the water. Bubble, 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 pop. Okay, so for our first experiment, we'll be doing water fireworks. And you'll need some water in a glass. So I have a glass of water over here. You'll need some oil. I have another glass of oil here. You'll need some food coloring. So I have the blue food coloring. And you'll need a fork. So the first step is to fill your water up into your glass with some room temperature water. It doesn't need to be hot or cold, just room temperature is okay. And you're going to put your 2 tablespoons of oil into another glass. So I have mine over here. And you're going to start by dropping 2 drops of your food coloring. Mine is blue. I'm going to drop 2 drops into my oil. 1 and 2. Okay, so you can kind of see right now, my food coloring droplets are just little drops in the oil, so they're not mixing together, right? So now what you're going to do is you're going to take your fork and you're going to mix up the food coloring. So you can see that they're becoming little droplets instead of the big droplets that they were from before. So when you start seeing that they're becoming little droplets and mixing throughout the oil, you can stop. You can see there's many more small droplets now in my oil. Okay, so you can take out your fork, and this is finished mixing. So now what you're going to do is you are going to pour your oil mixture into your glass of water. So you can see over here, and I'm going to pour it in, and you'll start to see some fireworks. Okay, you have to watch closely and you'll see what I'm talking about. So if you can start to see, some of the blue food coloring is coming down. So this is because the oil and food coloring did not mix when it was in my small jar. But now that I put it into the water jar, the food coloring is mixing with the water. So you can see the little bits of the food coloring mixing with the water now, because it's coming out of the oil and mixing into the water. They kind of look like jellyfish, don't they? You can keep watching. It changes into more and more fireworks. And maybe you can see different shapes inside of this glass too. You can see circles. I can see a heart shape. I can see more fireworks every second. There's more coming out. So you might be wondering how this works. The food coloring dissolves into the water, but it doesn't dissolve in the oil. And oil will always float to the top when it's with water. So the food coloring and oil will separate, and the food coloring and the water will sink to the bottom. Something else you can try is using blue and red food coloring, so using different colors of food coloring, and doing one drop of blue and one drop of red, and then mixing the oil and food coloring together. Okay, for our next experiment, we'll be making an ice fishing rink. So some materials you'll need for this is a bowl. So I'm using a clear glass bowl. You'll need some water. You'll need a stick and a string to attach to your stick. I used a pair of disposable chopsticks and a piece of, this is like yarn or kite string you can use. And you'll attach it at one end to act as a fishing rod. And then you'll have some salt and some ice cubes. So first thing you'll do is you'll fill your ice tray up with water and freeze it, and once it's frozen, then you can take it out and begin your experiment. I added some food coloring to the ice cubes, so it'll be a little bit more fun when they're in the water when you fish for them. First thing you'll do then is you'll add your water to your bowl. So you want to add enough water so that your ice cubes will float in the water. should be enough. So fill up your bowl. And then you'll put some of the ice cubes into the water. Okay, next thing you'll do is you'll put one end of the string on an ice cube. And then you'll sprinkle some of your salt on where the string is touching the ice cube. So if you watch carefully where you sprinkled the salt, your ice will start to melt around it. And your string will start to dissolve into that water. So you'll want to leave it for a few seconds, maybe count to 10 with your child. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and try to lift up your ice cube. Oops, didn't really work. Should we try one more time? I'm going to choose a red one this time. You can pretend this is a game with your child. And keep trying until you can catch all of your ice fish, your ice cube fish. So I sprinkled some salt, and we're going to count to 10 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and try to fish it out. Will it work this time? Oh, almost. It's a little bit too heavy, maybe. Okay, let's try another one. So I added some salt to this ice cube, and let's see if we can pull it out of the water. Wow. All three ice cubes came out at once. So make sure you put the salt where the string is so it can attach to the string and the ice cube together. Happy ice fishing! So the reason why you're able to catch the fish is because when you put the salt on the ice cube where your string is touching, the salt will make the ice start to melt. So when the ice starts to melt, the ice is still cold, so there will be a pool of water on top of where the salt was. And when it starts to freeze again, because the ice cube is still cold, it will freeze where the string was. And it will freeze around the string and hold the string in the ice cube. So it traps the string, and when the ice cube becomes hard again, when you lift up your string, you should be able to lift the ice cube out of the water. So other experiments you can try is using sugar or pepper or sand or flour instead of salt for this experiment and seeing if it works, if it doesn't work, and trying to figure out why. Thank you for joining us today at our Little Scientist episode number 3. I hope you enjoyed our new songs that we learned and tried some fun experiments with me. I hope you enjoy doing these experiments at home too. Thank you for joining us, and I hope to see you again next time. Take care. Bye-bye.